how you can help them help. It's absolutely amazing what they're doing there. So much so that my children run to the YMCA, have this call to this run to the YMCA. They're actually going to pilot a few more of these across the country now, which is really, really good to kind of get the kids off the streets and into a controlled area. It's really, really good.
I was going to ask a question, because I think it's one that we should always keep asking ourselves. I think, I mean, it's always a difficult question to answer, but I just like to be reassured how this board has added value to all of these things. In other words, would all of these things have happened anyway without Health and Wellbeing Board? Because it would have been more healthy here. So, make sure, please, be able to that these very kind of worthy projects and actions have happened as a direct result of our
brain. Around the table.
quality of, are we using this information to drive our commissioning strategy or plans? Have we got the kind of scientific information that's presented and we're able to articulate our responses? And secondly, particularly linked to the discussion we just had, how do we collectively, sitting around this table, add value to tackle some of these issues? And all that vision is something that we should prioritise and align with our funding. So where could we add most value by working together to tackle some of these issues? So it's to ask that you have a think about that as well, as I mean, because otherwise these are simple tasks and triggers. But I think the trick is to turn them into strategic intent and action. Okay. What we've done is take some of the key factors we get from the refresh for the strategic assessment, which is ongoing in the refresh. Part of everyone contributes to it. You may well be in the receipt of email from John Hines quite often asking for information and gathering information. So we are always sort of trying to move on a road program and trying to do that. And also seeking people's views on the key issues. So we want to keep them. The reason we came up with our key areas last time was to be asking more of what matters to them and those three key things as being what we should focus on. So we're going to continue to develop that people's contact with Jason, and I know John just said that it's been very constructive and helpful in trying to help us get some more complicated things because of the call for information out to counties. So if I can just take us through, and I won't touch on everyone because I know you can read these tweets themselves, but I just want to perhaps ask some specific questions. Clearly dementia, you have a dementia strategy, we are looking for the response to that. The question is, we've got some stats that less than half of those living with dementia are currently registered well diagnosed, and I've got a challenge back to the parents, so what we're planning to do is that a lot of change. That's the statistic in the question. Alcohol and smoking. We still have challenges around our health, we know that. Again, we prioritise our health and focus on. We have yesterday had some more positive information published in relation to alcohol related deaths in Wirral. On Wirral, our alcohol related deaths reduced by 13% in the last 10 years compared to an 18% increase in the cost of alcohol. So that's really quite interesting. life expectancy now is going down, but I'll draw your attention to the last one put on the sheet. This is the one that needs to be relevant, because it has a massive impact on our services. We have the worst disability for life expectancy in the country. Huge in the long-term conditions. Dr. And again, we've got issues with professional, but the positive thing around learning disability is we are quite active in our community and I think that's very important. So it does tell us to think about what we are. The last slide was some facts which are always sort of pushing some challenges about. I mean, if we reduce our hospital admissions by 9%, we could actually call all sorts of things, actually. And a couple of examples might be from the GP, but a couple of things would be something else.
Being a challenge, I think.
But nonetheless, it means that we can do some improvement on and then there is the fact that that tiny percentage of those population accounts for 20% of our emergency population. We know through medical testing that they've got to achieve a reduction without that reducing emergency admissions. And we know that's the deal. So have we focused on that point of view by ourselves? Do we know who they are and what we do with our health resources? So I think these are some of the facts that we might want to test out the models that we've now been using. I will finish the lecture because we can read the rest of the slides and the comments, but I suppose that I started off with a couple of questions here, which is, are we using this information to drive that decision? And where are the areas
Grace, okay, thanks very much. Okay, so that's some key facts for this. Chris?
Something I think we should be really concentrating on, which we are really where we are actually lowest in England. And that's around disability life expectancy. This is where perhaps we should all concentrate at least some of our energies on to try to do something about that. Because it's a little disability.
Sorry.
I think this is really helpful, and our council really uses this question to inform our plans. But I actually think some of these are alarming because there's so much to do. And I'm wondering whether we should actually highlight one that is on the right option B, which might be the marijuana. And then look to see what can we influence that, and have two or three targets that we all concentrate on that we do through our plans for vision or whichever way. But we try and link things more instead of just being, you know, we've got all these problems and issues, and then, you know, we don't seem to be getting very far. We're just practicing to tap into many things, and we should always think of things, or we'll and have it linked to one overarching objective that we all agree with.
Yeah.